My name is Melissa Soderberg. I'm at the School of Columbus Academy. It's great to see everyone here. I think this is the largest turnout we've had ever. And so it's just fantastic room filled with people of all different ages who love the school, which is great to see. And I know that you're having a good time talking with each other, but if I could just take a second to tell you a little bit about what's going on at the school. I thought I would take that chance to show you some things. First, I thought I'd tell you that I found a great picture of the senior class at Nelson Road campus on the bridge. I have no idea what age they are, but I will tell you, they have John Dietrich here, and they have Lou Schultz, right? And they have Scott Neal and Susie Carter. So they're definitely in middle school, and they're having fun. Scott told me that's a 7th grade architecture thing. So I'm going to do a little fairly brief kind of visual history of a few things. First, I thought many people in the room would love to see a picture of one of the big, most beloved teachers of the school. So half the room has no idea that this is Kelly Moody, and the other half of the room is decorated. I also thought it would be great to show the alumni. This is at the Centennial. These are the alumni teachers, and it was fitting to have a picture of Mark Barron in that group. Jamie Barron is a senior this year at Columbus Academy, his eldest son. Then I wanted to remember that the Nelson Road campus has still carries some architectural imagery on our campus with the Academy Hall, and I just thought I would put that up because we still have alumni who are from the Nelson Road campus. Then I found a wonderful picture of the land, the Woodfall Trust land of the Gahanna purchase that was made, and part of this is to teach you a little bit about what's happening at the school now. It's just fantastic. There's the campus with a bus circle and no buildings. So there's Academy Hall, as all of you know it. And here's Academy Hall now. Academy Hall has two wings that are being built on either side of it, and that's only about one-third of the building that's happening right now at the school. The idea of Academy Hall looking different is that it will probably look like this, we hope, when it's done, and it should be done by August of this coming year. So when the students return to school next fall, they will all have new buildings, and certainly they will have an extension of the upper and middle school as part of the new building. I then wanted to just do a then and now of the alumni luncheon, and I was so glad to see that Tom and Lori would come and be at the alumni luncheon today, because here he is. This has got to be the late 70s, early 80s, and the only reason you figured that out is because of the ties. So this is what Columbus Academy actually looked like 2 weeks ago. It has tons of dirt and building. This is the Lazarus Courtyard. These are actually trailers where students are having temporary classes. And in the beginning of the year, we probably made the mistake of calling them mobile classrooms, which the students immediately gave us a lot of trouble about, and they were right. And so they even made a film about being in a mobile classroom and decorating it for one teacher. I wanted you to know that while all this chaos is happening, the distinctive pieces of Columbus Academy and great relationships between student and teachers still exist. So I thought I would show you a little bit of this film that's made by the Academy Life student newspaper. This is Eleanor Rackoff, who's sitting among the senior class. And there are a few things you need to know. So she starts talking about mobile classrooms and trailers. That's kind of funny. She makes lots of jokes about the bad decorating habits of our faculty. So hopefully you'll be able to pick up on a few jokes.
So what are you looking for in terms of design? Do you have any specifics on your wish list?
I've printed off a few pictures that really speak to me.
Well, I really love these, but do you want flat walls and carpet?
You betcha.
Awesome. Now it's time for me to get to the drawing board. The next time we see your trailer, boy or those design cities. We're going to start out with a rep table to represent what the classroom will look like. We're going to put a whiteboard over here with exactly two dry eye ISO markers. Then we're going to put in the desks, face away from the clock, of course. Then over here, we're going to put Mr. Dow's desk, face at an angle, because that's pretty sophisticated. And over here would be a really nice place for fur. Then over here, we're going to put a cinder block mural to represent what it would be like to be in a real building. For some feng shui. And that looks like a great learning box.
I'll give you a sneak peek before the big reveal. Over here is the desk. It's in a great location because it's right near the only escape, the window, just in case there's a mobile classroom on fire or if really claustrophobic it is. Here's that friend I was talking about.
Beep.
This is just a decoration. Welcome to your new space!
Oh my goodness, this is amazing!
Do you like it?
It's a beautiful classroom.
That's because it is a classroom. It's just on wheels.
Well, how about that?
There you have it, folks. I'm a design genius. Tune in next time to Trailer Fantasy when we help get another Columbus Academy teacher.
Much AP engaging program has grown, it also, frankly, isn't terribly elite. All strong public schools have APs. AP is a universal advanced program and a nationalized curriculum. So we have many, many students taking it. What's the difference between 238 from 197? Okay, I wanted to talk a little bit about college. Another thing that I get in conversations often with alumni about is how our college list looks. But I think always we need to get a sense of, since much of my background was in college counseling, a sense of really how difficult things are. So if you look, in 1992, Millbury College presently is as hard to get into as Harvard was in 1992, with a 16-17% admit rate. The University of Pennsylvania admitted almost 40% of its applicants in 1992. It now admits 9.5% of its applicants, which means that it's one of the lowest admit rates. Vanderbilt University almost admitted 60% of its applicants in 1992. Now it admits 13%, which means that it's harder to get into than Cornell, Georgetown, Millbury, Amherst College. I think if those of you who remember Vanderbilt back in the 90s, you probably find that very hard to believe. That is how dramatic things have gotten. And then I wanted to just add the one caveat of what does it mean to someone when you tell them that there's a 95% chance they're not going to get into an institution? Harvard is at a 5% admit rate. That has dropped over years. And anything that we can do, anything that we encourage our children to do with a 95% failure rate, right? We approach with a little bit of delicacy. On the other hand, we have a fantastic college list, only made better by this early round of admissions this year. This is how most independent schools report how they do college matriculation. A five-year matriculation, day schools will always have at the very top the very strong local schools that also probably are a little bit of a bargain because they're cheaper and very strong. So we have two of those, and then the next is the University of Chicago and Washington University. And we have at 9, Denison. You can see how it goes. This is an incredibly strong list. If you go compare this to any other set of independent day schools, you would be amazed at how strong this is. I get to go evaluate other independent day schools that are very strong. They have lists exactly like this, no different. Lastly, I wanted to talk just a little bit about the traditions at the school. This school, we have some kind of interesting things happen at the end of the year. While we are constructing, we also wanted to create some new traditions, and one of them has to do with our veterans, which I'll talk to in just a sec. I have one more. I just have a set of kind of fun construction to see. This is really what our daily life is like. There I am. I read to the preschoolers, and then I started to show them what the Amish metal workers were doing up there. Because seniors, we hung some beams with their names on it in the back of the new fun arts in the back of Morris Hall, and they will be able to see those. And then this is a great picture we put Sam Tuckerman and Katie Beckman walking with welders right above them. This is not something we probably see on our, on our safety pictures, although I don't think it's very dangerous, but it's a pretty fun picture. So we wanted to get back to the veterans, we wanted to do something special to celebrate with them. I have a little short clip of a video on Veterans Day. We had the bell ring 486 times. This school has a tremendous history of sending people into the armed services. We also have many faculty who have served, and I thought I'd give you a sense of what it was like. Because for those of you who have been at the school a long time, I think it might feel like something you know. Thank you. they do every year is to develop a sense of reverence for the history of the school, people that have gone before, and certainly this luncheon has those parts to it, so I don't want to stall anymore, and we can get on